بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear Mashayikh, my brothers and sisters, I greet you with a greeting of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. All praise is due to Allah. Peace and blessings be upon our Prophet, upon his family, his companions, and all those who follow his path till Allah's day. What are some of the lessons that we can learn from the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina? In these few minutes, my dear brothers and sisters, I just want to mention three of them. Number one, it is very, very important not to take Islam for granted. I see a lot of Muslims nowadays, they take Islam for granted because they don't know much about their history. They don't know much about Islamic history. They don't know much about the biography, the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we go way back and we learn how much the Prophet had to sacrifice and all the challenges that he went through, this would make us be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even his companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, you know, leaving Mecca and going to Medina, leaving everything behind, leaving their homes and their wealth, leaving their friends, that wasn't easy even for them, but they did that solely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine if someone would have told you to leave Melbourne and to go to another place, to leave your wealth, to leave your house, to leave your friends, to leave everything behind. Would that have been easy for you or me? So it is very important, my dear brothers and sisters, to remember this event, you know, to remember this migration of the Prophet alayhi salatu salam, because this event changed the entire Islamic history. And even those people who lived even after them, all those ulama and scholars that have been in jail, all those people who sacrificed their lives and their wealth and their families so this Islam could come to us untouched, could come to us pure as it was revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Coming from Albanian lands of Kosovo, as I mentioned even before, we lived under communist regime, and I know how much my family and my people suffered to keep Islam with them. You know, my grandfather, every single day during the holy month of Ramadan, when he went to school, you know, fasting, the teacher would force every single student to drink water just to make sure that no one is fasting. And yet, they were able to keep Islam for them and to give Islam to us as well. I remember some of the scholars in our lands, just because they said La ilaha illallah, that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have been in prison for more than 25 years. Knowing all this, my dear brothers and sisters, it is important, and this should make us be grateful and not to take Islam for granted. Number two, my dear brothers and sisters, it is very, very important, especially for all of us that live in a Western society, to remember that we are ambassadors of Islam in this country. Whatever we do not just represent ourselves, we also represent Islam with us. A lot of people think that Islam is just going and pray five daily prayers in the mosque. My dear brothers and sisters, Islam starts when you get out of the mosque. Islam is a way of life, the way that you treat your family, the way that you treat your neighbor, the way that you treat your colleague. You know, we have a lot of Muslims that work with non-Muslims. So just to be mindful, the way that you represent yourself, that is the way that you represent Islam to those people as well. Number three, my dear brothers and sisters, When we talk about the Hijrah, the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum from Mecca to Medina, you know, after all these centuries, we still remember them and we still send salawat upon our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we make dua for the companions and for all those people who have sacrificed for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have left their legacy behind and their legacy is still alive. The question for you and me, my dear brothers and sisters, is what have we done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What kind of legacy we are leaving behind? Do you know that a lot of people live and they die? And when they die, no one even actually noticed that they have died. But some people maybe lived a short life, but the legacy that they have left behind, that legacy will remain alive for a long, long time. So it is important, my dear brothers and sisters, the things that we do, you know, it is important to think every single day, is there something that I would be proud of when I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Something that I have done solely for His sake. It is important, my dear brothers and sisters, the legacy that we can leave behind is through our children, through our next generation. The next generation and our youth, they are the next generation of Islam in this country. So we have to spend more time with them. We have to teach them the true meaning of Islam. We have to teach them not to take Islam for granted. Because a lot of Muslim brothers and sisters nowadays, they even change their names. They're embarrassed to identify themselves being Muslim. This happens because maybe we're not doing enough. And this is for myself being an imam of Albanian community in Melbourne. But this is for, and also being a parent, being a father. But this is for every single Muslim. Try to spend more time with your children, because they are our next generation in this country. And inshallah, this Islam will continue to get stronger and stronger and stronger. And the only way we can make this happen is if we go back and study more about our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The only way we will be able to practice Islam properly is if we know the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My dear brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all the good deeds that we do for His sake, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.